I'm here with Derek Mickelson, lead of the KRTP. It's Manitoba's tech transfer program. We're here performing a disease diagnostics on my stock. And if Derek, if you could speak a little bit about the program.
Yeah, so the monitoring program, the bee health monitoring program that was developed by the KRTP and by the advisory committee is really a service to the beekeepers to help them access the diagnostic services by veterinary diagnostic services in Winnipeg, and also to, you know, partner with the KRTP to have me come out and chat with the beekeepers and figure out ways that the KRTP can help the beekeepers and can offer, you know, direct support and guidance to each operation. So we're out here today, we're going to be sampling for Varroa, we're going to be sampling for Noseam viruses, and there's a new AFB diagnostic that is offered by the National Bee Diagnostic Center. They've spent quite a number of years developing that diagnostic where you can just take a sample of your adult bees and send it to them, and they'll be able to determine your level of risk of developing AFB in your colonies. So you might not actually be seeing it in your colonies, but there may be spore loads there that you can't see, and that could be detected in that sample.
Good deal. So what are we going to do first off? What's the process?
So we're just going to select 10 random colonies here. We'll sample each of those 10 for Varroa. We'll take one sample from each of those colonies, and then we'll just take kind of a large pooled sample from the whole yard for the rest of those diagnostics. Check for the queen, make sure we don't sample her.
So for the Varroa shake, how many bees are we looking for?
We're getting a full sample cup, 250 to 300 bees for the Varroa sample.
It's a hell of a brood frame though.
Yeah, that's a beauty. Should have froze that one. So I don't see her here. Now Ian tells me he's okay with not seeing the queen, and we'll shake bees into the tub and give it a quick look again before we actually take our scoop. Get a few more off this one, Ian.
All clear. This is the Varroa shake.
This will be the Varroa sample, yeah. Nice full sample cup. And then we'll just take a few bees here for our pooled sample.
One of the diagnostics I'm interested in is the American and European fowl brood analysis. Derek, could you explain a little bit about this test and exactly how it works?
Yeah, so basically the way it works is the National Bee Diagnostic Center has spent quite a few years developing this test where even if you're not seeing American fowl brood visibly expressing itself as a disease in your colony, there may still be spores kind of lingering dormant within your combs. So what you can do is actually take a sample of your bees, mail it to the National Bee Diagnostic Center, and they can come up with a level of, you know, low, medium, or high risk for actually seeing the disease in your colony based on the number of colony forming units that are expressing themselves when they're actually trying to grow the disease in the lab.
That really interests me. I haven't treated my hives for, it's been 5 or 6 years now. And to manage my American foulbrood infection, I've just basically stepped up surveillance. And I haven't seen it. I haven't seen it for a long time. Actually, I kind of forget what it looks like. But I'm looking for some kind of a metric to help me determine what kind of background level I have within my operation. That's where this test comes in. Being able to take a cupful of bees, send it off for analysis, and provide a metric back to me of a low, medium, or high infection, and just give me some more information on whether or not I have a problem festering within my operation. So if I get my analysis back at a low, then I know I can just, you know, carry on with operations as I am and just continue on with my surveillance. But if I'm noticing that my levels of American foulbrood, European foulbrood is getting medium or up into high, then I'm going to have to step up my management practices to be able to mitigate that issue, whether it be, you know, maybe incorporating antibiotics back into my treatment regime, or maybe rotate more combs more often, just trying to freshen up that nest and try to bring those spore counts back down into manageable levels. And this just helps me manage the issue with more information without actually having to see that vegetative state to know whether or not I have a problem or not. How many bees were you looking for in this live sample here?
In the live sample, probably about 500, 600 bees or so. We're going to be using it for the AFB diagnostic, viral analysis, and the Noseam diagnostic. So we need enough bees to split into each of those samples. So this is it's actually a laboratory shaking device, but we're using it in the field today to shape Varroa samples. So we'll put some washer fluid into each of our sample cups, shake them for about 5 to 10 minutes, and then we'll strain the mites through one of these little deep fryer baskets here and strain the mites out. Be able to count our mite levels right in the field. It's just a few too many bees in one sample cup to shake it as a full sample. So we're just gonna divide these bees into two cups, get a more accurate shake. Pour some into there. Do about half and half.
Let them shake.
So we'll shake these samples about 5 minutes or so. We'll go collect some more samples while they're shaking, and we'll come back and we'll strain the mites out and see how many mites are in there. Just put the basket in here, and that's half the sample and the other half in here. Those are just a big bucket of washer fluid here with some straining cloth. And we'll agitate the sample a little bit, get those mites to fall through the mesh. Put those bees aside and see if there's any mites. And that is clean as a whistle.
Oh, looks good.
No mites in there. Again, no mites.
No mites.
So,
well, that's good news.
Your apobar treatment is definitely working for you.
All right, so if I did have mites in there, what's the procedure around finding out whether or not I have tolerance or not?
Yeah, so if we had, we're saying over 3%, we would follow up with a miticide resistance test. So we would come back and collect some live bees from that colony and bring those bees back to the city to actually do the resistance test in the lab. And basically using a small piece of apobar in a vial and looking at how many of those mites are dropping dead over a certain period of time. And then shaking the rest of the bees to see how many mites are still on the bees and potentially resistant to apobar treatment.
So with that, I think I'm going to let Derek get back to work, and I'm going to head back to the bee yard and get some of my work done. I thank Derek for coming out and sampling my hives for disease. I look forward to seeing the results on the analysis.
Thanks for having me, Ian.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Okay.